Hi everybody, I'm Marina and welcome to my Ceramics Oasis channel. Last time I showed you how to use pinch pot technique to build flower pot. Today I'm going to show you how to build small vase using same technique. Let's start. For this project I'm going to use air dry clay and you can find link below. I got piece of clay and I will divide it on two even parts. Let's shape and make two balls. I push my thumb inside of this ball and I start rotate piece of clay. Use my palm like shaper. I try to make all walls same thickness. I build this cup and I will rest it here on the foam. Let's build second cup. And let's check. They should match. Now I have to score. I use needle tool for scoring. Here and score second one. I use water, but if you work with regular clay, you should use slip. For this clay, I can use water, that's fine. And mash them together. Now I have to connect them. I use this tool. And I will need reinforcing coil. Take a piece of clay. And I make a long coil. It and apply it around my vase, future vase. More here. It's my rice spoon and I love use it for shaping. Now I hold this vase, this egg in this position and I start smooth this coil in both directions. When we connect two big parts, we usually use reinforcing coil to make this connection more durable and more strong. Now I use rice spoon and shape it. Also, you can use plastic rib or metallic rib to smooth. If you do not have metallic rib, you can use old credit card or gift card and just cut it in this shape. Last step, I'm going to use sponge. You can use any cosmetic sponge or kitchen sponge. Okay, I will rest it on foam and I have to build food for my wings. I will make tiny donut and apply it to bottom of my wings. First, I start from coil. And you can see I make diagonal cut, same directions. Score here. And score to score opposite side. Add water or slip. And connect. I'm going to score here, add water, let's flat my waist slightly and add it here. And what I notice this foot looks too heavy for my waist, so I have to fix it. Just remove one segment and connect it again. Make it more elegant. Let's see. Much better. I connect outside, yes. And going to use tiny reinforcing coil inside. Dip my finger in water and smooth. Next step, I can use rice spoon. And I will need tiny reinforcing coil, so I took small piece of clay and put it inside of my foot. I can use handle of rice spoon. I want to make it very clean and accurate. Also, I would like to add a little bit texture for foot. I can use the side of this ceramic stool and just press. Okay, I will let it stay and dry. And next step, I'm going to build neck for my waist. Of course, it will depend on your favorite shapes and on your taste. I'm going to make it short, but you can build it longer. I place my ceramic stool inside. Now I can put my finger inside. Let's open it a little bit more. Keep my finger in the water and I can stretch my clay. See, I think this works very well for this shape. Next step, I'm going to trace up this neck. Check, it should be symmetrical. Now I can see it's slightly asymmetrical. But until my clay is soft, I can fix it, right? Okay. Okay, now I have to score inside of this circle. And I'm going to score here. Let's add a little bit of water. Put it here. And press. We will need reinforcing coil again. Now I will need bending wheel. But if you do not have any bending wheel, you can use any plate. Place your project on a plate and you can twist it. Flat it. And add it in connecting area between two parts. And I work up and down. Again, dip my fingers in the water and make it nice and smooth. You can use sponge. But please don't overwet your project. If you will overwet your clay, it will be very difficult to shape it and to work with it. Okay, you can see I got general shape. Now I will start thinking about decoration. And I would like to divide this vase on few areas. I'm going to keep top in dark brown, top and bottom in dark brown. And for middle, I'm going to use soap foam and acrylic paint. So to separate these areas, I will need coils again. Okay, let's place this coil here. I don't like to place them straight, so I'm going to make it more wavy. Something like this. Next step, I have to flat it slightly. And I can use rice spoon, but be very, very gentle. And next step, I will use my finger and smooth it. But you can see I smooth it only in one direction, up. And also I'm going to use similar technique and add my coil close to the bottom. Okay. And now I'm going to smooth this coil down. Be very gentle because clay is so soft. Okay. And I would like to add few coils around this neck for decoration. Tiny, tiny coils. So I need to make very, very long coil. Add water around this neck. And apply it. And I will add another coil here. So do not forget about water. Also, I would like to add similar texture here. Just press my tool. I check all my fingerprints and I'm going to smooth everything. I still didn't make any hole because my clay is so soft, and if I will make hole, everything will be collapsed. So I will let my vase stay and dry, probably for 1 hour, and after it I will use needle tool and I will cut hole. I let it dry for whole hour and now it's dry enough to make hole. I use needle tool, hold my vase and just cut this hole here, take opposite side and remove this material. Now I can reach inside and smooth it. I can put my finger inside and make it round. Okay. So I finish and I will let it dry whole week. After it I'm going to spray it and next time I will show you how to decorate. Thank you for your attention. See you next time.